my name is Ellen, and I'm the Education Coordinator here at the Land Trust for Tennessee. Today, I'm out at Glen Leven Farm, and I want to introduce you to our favorite tree here, and then I want to challenge you to go find your favorite tree in your neighborhood. So I'm standing in front of our Ginkgo tree. Ginkgo is really fun to say, so I want you to try and say it. Ginkgo. Yeah. Ginkgo trees are originally from China, but humans have planted them all over the world, and that's how this one got here. We actually have a picture from the 1950s of this little baby ginkgo tree. So we think this tree is at least 70 years old, which is pretty cool. It turns a beautiful yellow color in fall, and that's one of the many reasons why we love this tree, because it's so pretty when the colors change. All right, so as much as we love this tree, I did a little research and I discovered 5 fun facts about this ginkgo tree that I want to tell you about today. Fact number 1, ginkgo trees are really old. How old? Like 200 million years old. That's pretty old. They're known as a living fossil because fossils tell us about things that were alive many, many, many years ago, and so do ginkgo trees. Also, that means that ginkgos were around with dinosaurs. So cool! Maybe not this very ginkgo tree, but this ginkgo tree's great, 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 great grandparent could have touched a dinosaur. How awesome is that? All right, fact number 2. Ginkgo trees are really unique. First, look at their leaf. That leaf is pretty special. What does that remind you of? Reminds me of a fan. Yeah, there's no other tree with a leaf in the shape of a fan. So this tree is really special. Scientists group trees together in ways that they're similar. So if you look at the ways that ginkgo trees are grouped all the way up to its big group, it is the only one in there because it is so different. If you compare that to a sugar maple tree, sugar maples are where we get maple syrup from, you can see how it's grouped together, and it actually has 350,000 relatives. So scientists said, ginkgo trees are so different, we need to put them in their own group because they're so special. Fact number 3, ginkgo trees are dioecious. That means that there are male trees and female trees. The male trees grow flowers with pollen. That pollen is blown by the wind to the female tree, and then the female tree will grow a fruit. This is an example of a fruit from a ginkgo tree. And I actually found this underneath of our ginkgo tree. So do you think that our tree is a female tree or a male tree? Our tree, because it has a fruit, is a female tree. Awesome. Fact number 4. This ginkgo fruit is very special. If you come around Glen Leven Farm in the fall, when these fruit have fallen on the ground and people have walked around and it's pretty warm and maybe a little breeze is blowing, you might catch a little whiff of something and it doesn't smell very good. These fruits are really stinky. Yeah, it's kind of like dog poo, but really, really like 100 times worse. Really nasty. When these trees fall onto the ground, there's a seed inside that is pushed down, and then that seed actually grows into a new baby ginkgo tree. We have a bunch of baby ginkgos underneath of our mama ginkgo. Fact number 5, ginkgo trees are really tough. Remember how I said they were around with the dinosaurs? What happened to the dinosaurs? They went extinct. That means they're not around anymore. But ginkgo trees have survived. They can live in almost any conditions. So you might walk down the city streets and see a ginkgo planted between the road and the sidewalk, and it can survive there pretty well. So they're known for being really, really tough trees. Awesome. Thanks for joining me, guys. I know that you're probably thinking that ginkgo trees are the coolest tree ever, and that's because they kind of are. But there are other really cool trees out there, and my challenge to you is to go into your yard or neighborhood and find your own tree, learn all about it, and then introduce it to a friend or family member. You can also share it with us at the link below. We'd love to hear about it. Thanks so much for joining me, and we'll see you next time.